What do you think organisations could do to become more inclusive?
It's interesting that when people ask me that question, it's as though I have to say, well, look, you know, they have to go and get the magic dust and sprinkle it everywhere or say a prayer or hope. Actually, CEOs can change that overnight, yeah, just by making a decision that that is what I want to do and that is what I'm going to, yeah, go and do. And I think that there isn't any magic solution other than that. They need to set out a target and go and deliver it. And that sometimes can involve a cultural change, an approach, a proper program. And also the way, as we were talking about earlier, about attracting more women. Because I think what all women who work in industry want is we don't want women to be promoted because they're women. We want them to be recognised because they are phenomenally good at what, yeah, they do. Yeah. And that's important to us.
Do you think that, you know, positive discrimination is a solution?
Well, it's interesting. A report was out recently that the gender pay gap only really exists for women over 40. Mm. So one might say, well, a problem solved then, so we can all go home. But actually, unfortunately, that's not the case. And I think it's been proven that you get a 30% increase in your margin the more women you have, or there's a special number of women you have in your board or in your environment. I think that in relation to quotas, I'm not in favour of quotas for quota's sake, but if we don't start making inroads, then maybe that's something we should consider. But I think it starts right from the top when a CEO says, I want more women role models. And the reason that you need more women role models in your organisation is not because young women, you know, some, you know, women look up to Hillary Clinton or Oprah Winfrey or whoever, but actually in their working environment, they need a woman who is on the board, doing a great professional job, managing a family, and showing them that it can be done. Yeah. And I'm in great favour of not filling quotas by adding more non-execs, but by getting executives onto boards. That's what's absolutely key, yeah, in changing the culture. And when I talk about programmes, myself, Roland Rudd, Mervyn Davis, a few of us got together, Charles Dunstan, and we set up a company called Mentor. And Mentor takes women who are three or four rows down the ladder in their organisation and trains them and mentors them to get on their boards. And it's sponsored by the company themselves, and it's positive action, identifying talent and driving it forward so they are board ready. So when they get that position, they know what they're doing, why they're there, what they're contributing, absolutely, what their plan is, and you know, what their model is that they're gonna follow.